All right. I am live. And that is a fun thing. Just gonna make sure my stream goes live here. Come on.
Come on. There she goes.
Perfect. Excellent. Welcome everyone. And it is patch day. It is a wonderful day because it is patch day. And so we are going to be playing some of the rescaled mechs today. Because, hooray, look how tiny my catapult is! It's so tiny! Yes, this is my Jester. It's my 6 medium pulse build. It is super fun for short range, fast combat, and we're gonna be using it a fair amount. Unfortunately, I don't have my Phoenix Hawks. Or a Butterbee at the moment. I was supposed to be getting some, but the dropship is on its way and they haven't been delivered yet. So I'll just have to make do with what I have. But yeah, let's take a look at some of the mechs that are obviously going to be like, what? They rescaled it that way? Of course, if people have seen my rescale video, they've seen some of this stuff already. The adder got ever so slightly bigger. I don't know why. The adder really doesn't need to get bigger. Arctic cheetah stayed exactly the same, but holy crap, some of these IS lights have gotten so much larger. I mean, look at that fire starter. It's like a blimp now. I'm just gonna pump up the volume a tiny bit here, probably 0.4. See how that goes. And mech select. Then the oxides, all basically Jenners, they're blimps now comparatively. And so that'll be interesting to see how they do. And then spiders. I actually bought this spider here because I was going to be doing the comparison. Like, I made the comparison video. I had to buy the spider because I normally never run spiders. That's just me. It's a mech that just doesn't work with me. But my God, this thing's huge now. It makes me happy because I hate shooting spiders. Now they'll be really easy. Although, oh my God, locusts are so bloody tiny. They're just going to be the most annoying thing in the world. I'm going to have to make sure I run some streaks in case I run into a locust because I don't want to have to deal with them. Because screw locusts. That's all I have to say. But yeah, Blackjack's got a bit bigger. This will be really interesting. They'll be a little bit easier to kill. They didn't gain any durability to go with it. So some of these mechs are just going to get a little bit easier to destroy. Cataphract stayed exactly the same. Crab got a lot bigger. It is now appropriately sized for its weight. And oh my God, look at the Nova. It's so tiny. I'm going to be using the Twin Peeps Nova a bunch because oh, that platform is already really good and I can do good work on it. And now it's just going to be even smaller, so it's going to be even harder to hit it while it's flying through the sky. So, yes. And Shadowcat, tiny bit smaller. Rest of the mediums are just slight changes, but nothing really huge. Archers, holy crap, they got taller. Look how tall that thing is. But, I mean, it does basically have no waist to it. Like, the waist is non-existent. All this space here and here underneath the arms has no mech, so by volume it's probably correct. But Black Knight's much taller, much easier to kill them now. Cataphracts still a bit of a barn door, but they're okay. And then oh my God, look at the catapult, it's so tiny. And the Jester, you can now repaint it. So I've painted it in Novacat colors because I did not like the sort of Cheshire Cat design on it. It was just like, eh, whatever. Don't really like that design. So the fact that when they remodeled it, it got full camo support makes me very happy. And then dragons. Oh, I might have to take dragons out today as well because much smaller. Don't know if they got any additional quirks. I can't remember. But yeah, very good stuff. And then Holy crap, his head is touching the top of the screen. What? Look how tall grasshoppers are. Hellbringer basically didn't change. Very happy for me, because I like my Hellbringer as it is. But that's strange. Where's its, Oh, right, because I had it set up as the, four large laser. I normally have this as the four meds and a Gauss, which I'm going to switch back to, because that is my preferred build on this thing. As a Gauss. And, there's a four meds. Three and a one. Perfect. And then, I think a trio of ammo, or a quad of ammo, something along those lines. I remember I take an extra ton for a CW, just in case I need to sit at the back and plunk shots for a long duration of time. So, save that up. And we'll continue our sort of preliminary inspection of some of the rescales in my garage. Hello, Squeaky. And Jason, welcome to the show. We're going to be streaming for two and a half hours. It's 6 p.m. for me. I'm going to go until 8:30 my time. And, yeah, I'm going to have some fun. I'm going to play with some catapults because my Phoenix Hawks are not here. The dropship has been delayed, and so they will get here eventually. And, oh, man, look at how much shorter the Vulture is, the Mad Dog, with its much more bent legs. That is quite nice. And the same with quick draws, they are much smaller. Everything's nicely compacted in the IV4 now. And Wing Protector, like the Orions are about the same. Timber's got shorter, a little bit more leg bend, which is quite nice. And yeah, Thunder's got smaller, which is awesome. Because it just makes the structure quirks. Although the structure quirks on the Thunderbolt came down, specifically the Top Dog. It's one of my favorite ones, because it had the plus 20 to the CT. It's come down a little bit. It's now only plus 16, which is an entirely reasonable change considering the fact that it got smaller. So it's a little bit easier to twist damage throughout the different sections, and so a little bit less structure quirks there, because you'll be twisting better. One thing I didn't expect is Battlemaster's got a little bit smaller. I don't know, I just didn't expect that. I thought because they were sort of barn door sheety, you know, like it's a very tall, broad mech, I thought they would get bigger, but they actually got smaller. Because basically, the more taller and broader a mech is, the more chance it was going to get bigger. Or the more ball-shaped the mech was, like Dire's and Catapults, the more chance it was going to get smaller. But, yeah, Battlemaster's actually got a little bit smaller, which is interesting. And then Dire, a lot skinnier in the front. Just like they taked it, they took it, and they just sort of like grabbed on one arm and grabbed on the other arm and just sort of squished it together a little bit. But yeah, I think Executioners are like super tall now. Oh yeah, it's like off the top of the screen. They need to zoom this back a couple clicks now, because Executioners are so tall. Should go to like whatever the tallest mech is, Executioners, probably Executioners, and make it fit, and then scale the rest in there. The catapult is small. I don't think the cicada changed at all, as far as I remember. I did do my patch, not the patch video, the my scale comparison video. I think the cicada is basically about the same, if not maybe ever so slightly bigger, but really comparatively to a lot of them, it's not that much of a deal for the cicada, at least. Yeah, Battlemaster's got the thick arms. Maybe that's why it didn't get too much bigger, because it's got these great big old pauldrons, basically. It's like it's in World of Warcraft. Look at this, World of Warcraft shoulder pauldrons, just absolutely huge, this sort of thing. Oh, in comparison to the catapult. Oh, I totally get what you're saying. Yeah. Well, look at here. We got the catapult jester right there, and then we'll switch to the cicada. It's just like, what? But I mean, the cicada is basically one ball, and it doesn't have any arms. And the cicada is the 40 tons. So this is 25 tons more at 65. So what, I would say the ball center maybe is about the same. Maybe the catapult's like a few tons extra more, but the arms bring up the tonnage, I would say, so that it fits the 65, hopefully. I do feel like the catapults are definitely the most sort of bally mech. Like, it's like a ball with legs running around. So, it is definitely one of the ones that would get smaller if you were to rescale them. But, we're gonna give these mechs a try. I'm gonna run my jester for a fair amount today because the jester is awesome. And this is my build on it. We've got XL350 to get me up to a blistering 93.8 kilometers an hour. Got six medium pulse lasers that are absolutely great at ripping people apart. Two AMS with a ton and a half of ammunition. Two jump jets, filled out the rest with heat sinks. And it's got really high heat management. This thing can shoot a whole crap ton before it starts getting hot. And that means it can just keep on going. You can keep on running, doing strafing runs, keep hitting people. And it's got medium pulse laser range to increase the medium pulse range because really they're very, very, very short range. And then AMS range 5. And radar deprivation now with the minimap, although thankfully minimap has been said that it is changing, so you don't have to worry about that anymore. I think I'm going to put an AMS overload in here so that the AMS shoots a little bit faster. Well, I guess it's 2.5 damage now, so yeah. Make my AMSs amazing because I got two of them. So, if anyone tries to shoot missiles at me, they're just gonna freaking eat your missiles down, and I'm just gonna cackle as I charge at you and rip you to shreds with medium pulse lasers. Which reminds me, oh my god, so long ago when the Jester first came out, and I actually, me and my buddy from Clan Novacat both got Jesters, like day one, and we teamed up with four AMS. And there was like some super like Lerm 80 stalker hanging out on the island in Crimson Strait, like out in the water. And so then we're just like, we have four AMS and like thousands of rounds of ammo. Let's just push. And so we just charged at the guy, and he started Lerming us, and we just killed him. He just couldn't do any damage to us by the time we got to him because four AMS going like crazy with AMS overload was just too much. Why not large laser range module? Because I don't have any large lasers. I have medium pulse. This mech is to be a fast striker. It's meant to get around the sides really quickly. It's meant to poke. It's meant to prod. It's meant to just be a little bastard in somebody's side. Let's see here. All these are good. I can work with all these. We could see what the new forest colony is like. But the mining collective is really popular, so I'm guessing it's gonna win. Yeah, it's gonna win. As this loads in, I'll take a nice, wonderful glass of water. Because I'm talking a whole bunch, and I need to stay hydrated. I'll tap here. See, 17 people are watching. Thank you for coming out and checking out the stream. We'll be going for about 2 to 2.5 hours, and we'll be playing around with some of the rescaled mechs. I know the stream name is Phoenix Hawks and Butterbees and stuff like that, but unfortunately, the The dropship has gotten delayed, and my Phoenix Hawks and Butterbee has not arrived yet. So I just have to deal with my catapults. Just dealing with new minimaps and quirks like everybody else. Yes. New minimap. It's getting fixed. I love it. And my prediction was entirely correct. I knew it. The instant I said it on Friday that I was going to be vindicated and I was going to be correct. You know what I mean? Is vindicated the right word? It's more of like I was proven wrong. You know, I was falsely accused and then I was proven correct later. No, I can't remember what the right word for that is, but I was correct. I made the call that they would hotfix it almost immediately, and they are. So, moving forward here, I do like the, like, if you look down at the minimap, there is some ones that are really good. Some things are really good about this. The fact that they have the A and the BC, like the ABC, the 1, 2, 3 on the outside, and you can easily reference. You don't have to, like, because sometimes it was troublesome to figure out what the position was because somebody was standing on top of the letter, you know, that kind of thing. But now it's fine. You can easily read off the location. And I'm used to doing that because I make maps for a living and we use those kind of coordinate systems, like outside reference coordinates, that kind of stuff. So that's fine. Ooh, there's an enemy right here. Arctic cheater, eh? It's also an enemy moving. No, it's on the way on the other side. Okay. Let's try to sneak this Arctic cheater here. Hi. Wait for him to land. Just put a good hit into him. A little bit too much enemies there, so we're going to drop back. Although we did do some good damage. Moving around here with our superior mobility. We're just going to keep flanking. You hear that radar deprivation go off, showing that we have managed to hit the enemy, not hit the enemy, get the enemy to lose lock on us. So we flank around the far right side. I'm basically ignoring the minimap. I'm just not using it. I'm using my mental picture of how the battlefield is building to figure out where I should be going. There's an opponent there. I'm considering even going further around the right side. Almost flanking really far. This might be a very bad idea, but hey, I'm having fun. And let's jump. Because I have the jump jets, might as well use them. At 25%. Now, there was opponents here. Where did they go? As we use our vastly superior speed to try to catch them out. Although this isn't looking good for our first match because we're already down two. But hey, you can't win every match. New target. We just gotta do the best we can. Oh, there's a jester up there. Put a nice hit into him. Ooh, yes, I put that side torso down. He will most likely be trying to nurse that side torso for the rest of the match. So I'll be looking out for him. And I know how he got up there. I know this route. Jump to here, and then you jump up. But come on. I just need to nick that side torso. He's running because he knows.
At 25%.
Almost. But nah, it's not looking good for us. Looks like our team will lose this one. As he runs away, as expected. I would do that in this situation. Can still pull this back though. That jester is quite low. We can just go in there and promptly execute him as soon as we get in. Down, excellent. We'll drop back as we have opponents in our rear. Ah, there's another one down. Excellent. Here comes somebody. Ready for him? Battlemaster putting the shot into his side torso. He's most likely an XL engine. Most likely with that speed. So we're just going to take away that side. He's super crit. He'll be nursing that forever. Battlemaster, right torso. Good, good, good. He's down. It's still anyone's game here. Oh, that's a Kodiak. We'll twist that damage. Twist that damage. Try to get back around that corner. Nope, we got more enemies behind us. Alright. Two enemies behind us, one enemy in front of us. One enemy is better than two, so we're heading back up. Nope, we get taken out. Yeah, well. We can't win every match. We'll quit out of there. And try something else. We have 32 people watching. Thanks for coming out. Pinrider, no, you did not miss almost everything. We are just starting. And what engine is in my Jester? It is an XL350. It's 6 medium pulse, XL350, 2 AMS. This is the build. It's really fun for running around and harassing people. But yeah. What else can we try here? Now, a while ago, I used to play a lot of catapults. Like, back before all of the, clans came out and stuff like that. You can see I actually have almost every catapult, like, mastered out. Because I played them a whole bunch. Now, I've since gotten rid of them because, I know, if I want to play an LRM carrier, I can play the C, instead of playing the C1, I can play my Mad Dog now. Or I can play my Timberwolf or something like that. Like, I know there's some things in there that are just like, hey, but quirks and stuff like that. And I'm like, I already have enough mechs. I mean, I have, what do I have here? I have like 96 mechs. It's like, when am I ever going to really play that many mechs? But one that I did really enjoy, and one that I'm going to be repurchasing right now because of the rescale. I'll eventually be getting a Butterbee, but the dropship is slow. I'm going to be repurchasing a K2 because I think these things are cool. It's like the Jester in that sense of the different arms on the catapult. Instead of being the missile bays, it'll be the direct fire. But yeah, actually, that's one of the K2 builds that I really enjoyed. It was a K2 with UAC 5s and 4 mediums. And I'm going to rebuy one of these. I'm not sure what to put on it as of yet. But I'm going to figure something out. But we'll get that down. I won't do Mech Labin just yet. Let's run something else here. Let us run. I do have my Nova with the two PPCs. I also have this Nova, which is a bunch of small pulse lasers, 4 on each side. Oh, I know that you freaking sent me a chat prior. Pew, 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 pew. God. Hey, how do I pronounce that name? Scringy? Am I doing that correct? Scringely? Welcome to the show. But yeah, I think I'm going to try the, I'm going to do the small pulse. Now let's do small lasers because it gets just a little bit more range. But yeah, this Nova can do some nasty shit. You can't fire everything at once. That will just cook your goose. But you can fire a whole bunch at once, and it really kicks ass. Now, I have 2 tons. What to do with it? Maybe this is too many. Maybe 5 on each side. And more DHS. And then a targeting comp. Call it good. See what I got for modules. I don't need those small pulses anymore. I'll take the small range and the small cooldowns. And almost want to take off seismic sensors. I don't think it's going to be very useful. Let's see here. Scringly. Am I saying that right? I hope so. But yes. We're going to try out small laser Nova. See how that goes. Yeah. Mini-map stuff is going to be done. It'll be fixed later. It's all good. We just have to bear with it for a couple days. But yeah. You heard that the command wheel target spotted marker stays on mechs after you lose lock? Oh! That's interesting. I'm gonna have to try that out. Oh, you sending me public groups invites? Okay, fine. I'm not going on TeamSpeak with you, though. We're gonna Nova that up here. If anyone wants to join in, I'm assuming it's okay. If anyone wants to join in, send Priya a friend invite or something like that. We'll get a group going here, and we'll just kill people. And I most likely won't be on a TeamSpeak or anything like that, because I just want to comment on what I'm doing. But we could all get a group and just do a bunch of Novas. That'd be fun, if you're interested. But, yeah. Mech rescale is awesome, as well as Quirk. Map change is great, can get used to. Yeah, I still want to try out Forest Colony at some point this evening. I want to see how that expanded goat path makes for flanking and stuff like that. Because, I don't know. It'd be interesting. Think it wouldn't be so disliked if it rotated and can choose your zoom level. I totally agree with you. One of the main reasons that after not having it, you know, you get that stuff where you have something, and then when somebody takes it away, you go, oh wow, I really use this. Like, you realize how important it was for you. It was the fact that when I'm normally playing, I did not realize how much I use those directional arrows, the cone of vision, and the arrow for my leg orientation. I just didn't realize how much I relied on that in order to orient myself. Like, I'm finding myself getting lost in which way my legs are putting, like, pointing right now. It's like, what? I can't tell. And before, I'd just be able to, like, not even look at it, but just peripheral vision. Look down, see, oh, hey, my legs are pointing left. I need to start rotating. And, yeah. I don't know. Frozen City! Ah, yes, he chose it. Okay, good. Because the leader is choosing map. I have no control over everything. But 100% Frozen City. Oh, somebody who doesn't want Frozen City. Somebody's taking Termaline. Now. Frozen City. Beautiful as heck, I'd have to say. Because they have all of the new weather effects, like on Polar Highlands and stuff like that, with the sweeping snow, and they're just bloody beautiful. Oh, and man, I'm just checking it now as we're loading in. We got 40 people watching. Thanks so much for coming out and checking out the stream. All right, let's kick some butt in our small laser Nova. It probably would have been better if I was in the ERPPC Nova, most likely. I would have liked a shorter range map, but I guess no one's really played on this map, at least the new versions of it yet. Yeah, oh well. 30-second delay. That is fine. Reactor online. There'll be a different delay for people around the world. I personally have a 10-second delay for my own stream, which sounds kind of funny, but like, it's your own stream. Why do you have a 10-second delay? I don't know. I can't tell. But I know Pariah is in southeastern United States, and so he's got 30 seconds. Who knows? But let's move over. Let's move forward here as we see the beautifulness. I guess some of the beautifulness has been turned off because I don't have my settings fully on here, which I should probably turn on just for at least one match. Let's see how my frame rate goes. A little bit lower, but going okay. But you get all of this blowing snow and beautiful effects here. Okay, let's move forward. This is like, normally there would be a sort of lower city. We'd come around here and be heading towards Brawl City, but now it's open terrain. And we cannot see that. And alright, we get target spotted. And we'll go affirmative. And we'll move forward. I love that. We gotta get to...
Enemy Kodiak on the saddle area.
Try out that... Enemy spotted. And
that's Echo 3 or Delta 3.
Oh, we lost him, and then he disappeared, but we see his indicator on the minimap, at least. That's interesting. We're gonna try to flank right here, I think. I think we've got the cover to move up through here. You got this low ground.
I'm just kind of
Bravo, Mauler.
And I think we can cut right. Yeah, we got enough ground elevation here so that we can get up close. And we're just alternating the small lasers, stripping metal. Woohoo. Get back into cover. Oh man, we can see the seismic and it's so huge. Let's push right. We can alpha everything. Does okay amounts of damage. We got the Phoenix Hawk. Whoa, hello. That's not who I wanted to see. I wanted somebody with
Delta Sectors is wide open.
Less firepower looking at me. Come around the side. Put some shots in. Get back into cover. We do have a light in our backyard.
There will Charlie 5 for about 4 minutes.
Whoa, hello. We're getting pushed in. This isn't good. They just decided to move, and we're overheating. No! No, I'm down. That didn't work out very well. We kind of got swarmed. But, oh well.
Kodiak Echo.
I'm going to go back down to the settings of my video. Oh, and I have to set everything back to where I wanted it. People can see what I do for my settings. Texturing is high, shadows is medium, shading.
India Kodiak shutdown.
Is low. Post processing is medium, particles are low, details high, effects are low. I think that's how I do it. Yeah, well. Shit happens. Get out of that match and figure out what I want for my next mech. We should upgrade that K2 and take it out. Where is it? Where's my K2? I just bought you. Now to spend a bunch of C-bills on you. Oh god, it's so bad. Look at this armor. Ugh. We gotta rebalance this. Ubu runs like 20 armor on their back. Ugh. Yeah, but there's nothing. We don't need to complain about the map anymore. We did our job. The map is changing. So, yeah. Now, I think one of the old builds that I did on this thing was 4 large lasers. And then, I think an XL3. And then we just... Ooh, oh, that's a standard heatsink. Doubles, okay. And we just filled this thing with doubles. I didn't think we even put on any of the upgrades because those just took up too much space. And yeah, just like that. We'll give 4 large lasers a try. Oh, and I should probably module this thing up and paint it. Come on, save faster. I will do quad, medium, and 2 UAC-5s in a bit here. I'm going to do a couple games with 4 large lasers. Oh, there's range. And do I want any mech modules and consumables? I'll throw on some cool shots for fun. Nah, I'll take a cooldown, fine. I don't need any modules on this mech for now. Oh, they've confirmed the time. 5 p.m. tomorrow. Wow, that's fast. Like, that's even faster than I thought it was going to happen. I thought it was going to happen by Friday. I thought they were going to be, like, resilient for the first day or two. But they just were like, oh shit, and they reverted. And now camo spec. Now, this is like shows how back that I owned catapults. I learned the hard way that permanent patterns don't go between mechs, and I have permanent camo pattern Sherman on catapults. Because I didn't know that they didn't transfer between mechs at the time, and I still think that's a stupid system, but I own Sherman. So this guy's gonna be Sherman. I know the rest of my guys are like, what is it? The, whatever it's called, Snowfall. But, yeah, it's something like that. Some sort of, like, good old-fashioned Sherman camo. Maybe, like, a good, what's a good green? Like a khaki and green or a khaki and brown sort of thing? That's what I used to run on my catapult before the clans. Eh, that's good enough for now. There's no reason to do it, but this is before I knew that. Like, this is how old catapults are for me. Like, I haven't run catapults since, like, not knowing that. So, I have permanent Sherman on them for some stupid reason. But getting into another match here, I will be a little bit more tanky. I'll be a little bit farther back from the battle. Yeah, I'm just going to alt-tab here because I want to check that Twitter. So you'll hear the sound cut off. That's just because I have MechWarrior in the background right now. Ooh, there it is. Russ Bullock, looking like the hot fix maybe tomorrow at 5 p.m. That is the aim. Nice changes all will enjoy. Official post tomorrow. As I can't read, but all right, we did it within how many hours was that? Okay, so that was 10 minutes ago. It is 6:36 my time, so just say 6:30. Patch came out at 10, probably went live at 11, so in 7.5 hours. So fast it was. You haven't run a catapult since first day of open beta. Yes. I haven't run a catapult other than the Jester in years. Since, since Clans came out. And I sold the vast majority of my superfluous IS mechs. But, oh well. Minimap change will happen, and we don't need to talk about it anymore. It's over. We can talk about the rest of the patch, because I really do like the rescale. I think the new map is good, we just have to get used to it. Frozen City, and Forest Colony, we need to give a try. Although, none of these maps are maps that changed. You know, I honestly think that for the first few days, one of these things here, like the far left one, should be guaranteed the new map, and it should have a little banner that says on it, new, you know what I mean? Like, say, like, this is the screen here, of a little banner that goes diagonally in the top right corner that says new on it, or updated, or something like that, so that people know, oh hey, that's the new map. So people who have no concept of the changes of the game, the people who just log in to play whatever, they get the they get this thing saying, "Oh, hey, that's a new map. Maybe I should try out that map, see how it goes." But we are loading in here. We've got Steel Jaguar on our team. We got Magician, the Pie Maker. Those guys are amazingly strong. But oh wow, look at the enemy team. We've got 228. They've got Panic Button. Oh man, this is going to be one hell of a fight. Got no love for the Phoenix? I got no Phoenixes. Because the dropship is slow. The dropship has not dropped my package off yet. So I may need to wait a few days until my package gets here, in that sense. Because reasons that I can't explain. It's stuff in the background, just
Reactor online.
But yeah, I wish I could be playing my Phoenix Hawks. I wish I could be playing my Butterbee. I want to stick 4 medium lasers on there, and,
Need assistance!
Okay, is this going to be a need assistance spam? Let's do it.
Negative assistance!
Oh, man. Sorry. I love some people in this game.
Sorry. Negative. Need assistance. Sorry.
Oh, yes.
Need assistance. Need assistance.
We shall see. These guys are obviously doing it because they're just dicking around with it. I actually haven't found much of the command wheel abuse in normal gameplay. It's not that bad, actually. We'll see if people are dicks about it, but for now, it's good. We've got our Sherman catapult here as we charge forward. We've got our 4 large lasers. How does it heat if we fire everything at once? Actually not bad. Wow.
Affirmative.
Yeah, I could probably just be firing all 4 at once all the time now. Oh, there's a UAV. Took that out. Excellent. Because we like to help our teammates.
Acquired.
And we do that by taking out UAVs. I'm moving forward here. We got some strong enemies on the other teams. We gotta watch out. We gotta make sure that we're not gonna get our head blown off, basically. Because it looks like this Phoenix Hawk is getting pushed back. We are gonna cautiously move to the right side. Try to push around. Don't see anything right there. We do see some fire coming from that side. So we are gonna peek up. And we do get a nice drain into the side torso of that Jester. We're going to throw in heat vision here, just so that people show up a little bit better. And another really good drain into his side torso. Oh, there's somebody around behind. An Arctic Cheetah.
Warning incoming.
Incoming missiles. We're going to moved aside. Oh, there was a UAV as our ally takes it down and saves our ass from the enemy missiles. And no, we lost the magician. There, it will be less magic in this
new target acquired
match now. That little locust makes me want to kill it. There's a catapult here.
Warning, incoming missile.
Oh, our missiles. Thankfully, they're going to be spread out fairly well on our cockpit. Not our cockpit, our entire torso here. So we're pretty good for spreading damage. We do want to watch that catapult. Hodges M6s do hurt, but he is fairly easy side torso.
That's here. A moving flank in us.
New target acquired.
We are going to re-aim. No, that jester. Not the jester. The locust is not going to come back up. Let's move back to our team. See, can we take the top? I'm hoping we can. Yes, they have abandoned the top.
New target.
We can move
acquired.
Up and get some shots on the Atlas on the left side here. But we are losing people. No! Oh! Felt like that was from behind, but it was from
new
front.
Target acquired.
Kodiaks? Kodiaks are OP? No! We're losing! Will I get a win this match? Will I get a not this match, but will I get a win this evening?
Target
this is a very
acquired.
Important question.
New target acquired.
We take the side off that Timberwolf, I believe it was, as we charge down, trying to put some flanks on. Got
new
some enemies below.
Acquired.
Jester, who's super low.
Target destroyed.
And he gets taken out.
Warning incoming.
No missiles.
Critical damage. Large laser.
No, that's no good. That's the death. As panic button cores me out through the CT.
Yeah.
We'll win some games eventually, right?
Center torso, critical damage. Right torso.
Well, we don't win any games for like, I don't know. A few more times. I'll go back to solo queue, but it's group queue with only two is kinda painful. Especially when you're trying to play like non-super meta mechs, because you know people come out there with all of their Kodiaks and things like that and just want to kick your ass. Right. So, silly little catapult. It did not work perfectly this time, but we'll give you one more go. One more go with the catapult. And then we're either going to try a new build on it or move on to a different mech. Says Pariah. What? You don't like losing? Ah, it's okay. As we wait for our match here. I want to see the new forest colony. I want to see how that plays. It intrigues me. Out there, what mech should I play next? I should, like I do normally do, I'm gonna get my piece of paper here. And we're gonna make a list. And I'm gonna work through them. As we wait for the searching, which is taking far too long. Silly two-man queue. So hard to get a match. Oh, there we go. Frozen City!
Do it! Yes.
What should I play for my mechs? I know I have to do the 2 times UAC 5 and 4x ML K2. But anything else people want me to see? Because, yeah. Want to see some Executioner gameplay? Okay, I'll throw an Executioner onto the list. Executioner. How tall it is. Got an Ebon Jaguar. Cauldronborn, as a Pinrider says. Ebon Jaguar. As we get mechs to play, I want to do my Nova again. The Nova with ER PPC. And let's see here. Good luck, have fun to our opponents.
Reactor online. Sensors online. Weapons online.
And where are we spawning?
All systems
we're
nominal.
Still in the recognizable section.
Bob catapult, right?
What?
Wow, this is a nice storm.
Why would he blame me for the minimap?
I mean, it's nasty. Visibility that looks way more realistic than what we had before.
It was not my decision. What? We're moving forward here. I do like these new indicators. Like, I'm okay with losing the directional. The indicators look cool. But, moving forward, this time we have range. We actually can shoot things that are far away from us. So, oh god, there's some PPCs coming in. I can't go enemy spotted because I can't get them with my radar contact.
Affirmative.
So we need to move forward in order to...
Button down and enemy spotted across the street. On the other side of the river.
Yeah, I can't do enemy spotted because I can't get them on radar. But, oh well. Shoot some laser beams. Now, this does seem like it basically turns into a snipe fest here. Ow! Okay, I'm not poking ever again.
Double back around. Close to that distance.
Yeah, they're just sniping us from this side.
We can probably get closer. Move over, so.
Let's just move. Let's just leave this direction. Because their position there on the other side makes it almost impossible for us to push up. I'll just fall back and reposition. Going around this left side.
We can get closer, but I don't think we can get all the way.
And we'll come around here.
Run, assault, paint, run.
Target acquired.
Oh, you can just sit there. Sit there and just die.
We have one opponent close here. Try to see if we can catch him out. Oh, yeah, here they come.
Acquired.
There's that UAC 5 chain. Does so much damage. As that Jaeger mech gets blasted. Ooh, there are the opponents around the right side, but oh wow. We're in a tight situation here. Got really loud there really quickly. Put some hits into the Marauder. Just barely being able to see him. Thankfully, with my newly modeled catapults. Basically, all of my weapon hardpoints are eye level or higher, which really helps with fighting these guys. But I'm definitely not going to be able to win the trades with a dual Gauss Jaeger at this speed, at this range. So, not even going to try. But I will happily duel a shadow cat here. We are in okay position. I'm just gonna wait for some cooldowns. Come on, Marauder. Or Warhammer. I don't know, Mex.
I'm too tired.
He's down. Excellent. The Warhammer is moving forward, holding this position. Try to sneak some shots around this side.
New target.
There is
acquired.
Nova in the backfield. Take some pot shots into him. As he is just slightly outside of our range. Our range is 500. He's at 6. He is moving closer to us, and he has radar deprivation, which makes it incredibly hard to hold these locks.
New target acquired.
Oh, here it comes. They're pushing on our position, and you're RDing me, really, a single mech, and I dodged it. Moving back here, resetting. Oh, they put up a UAV. People seem to think that archers are DOA in this patch because they got so much taller and they didn't really get any more structure. But yeah, we'll see. Pariah killed himself. What the hell was that? Get another good hit into the Warhammer. Take off all of his armor. Come on, Warhammer. Poke your little nose out. So we dodged those PPCs.
New target.
Not those ones.
Left torso, critical damage.
Good hit in there. We gotta get back though. Okay, we're in cover. This is a close match. It is really hard to tell where the battle lines are. But we are gonna stop up here. Take out that UAV. Because it's not one of ours. And I'm gonna get out of here and head back towards some of my friendly indicators. I can't tell where the battle lines are. And I feel scared. Come here, big brother Atlas. Protect me. As our guys go down here. Oh! We get shot through. We're just not having a good match. Or good evening so far. We're getting our ass handed to us. Let's see here. We know how this is going to end with our failure. But oh well. We gotta try harder, man. Are we even getting our points here? We got our turn. Excuse me, I burped. We got our 260 points, so enough for the event at least. So, that's something. Alright, I think it's enough of the four large laser K2. I'm gonna try one more build on it, and then I'm gonna move on from the mech entirely. This is a build with, and I truly enjoy, it's the same engine. But you put on some endosteel, you put on a pair of UAC-5s, and then four medium lasers, and then a fairly decent quantity of ammo, something like 6 tons, so you can shoot all the things, and then some double heat sinks, and yeah. We're gonna drop the large laser modules. We got medium lasers. And I won't go for the UAC-5 modules yet. Nothing we can do about it. We lose. We can only worry about our own amount of playing, our own damage, our own influence on the map. But yeah, I really have no concept of where the battle lines are with the minimap as it is, so the battle is much more frantic. Like, I'm not sure where I'm supposed to be looking, that sort of thing. So, yeah. Ready to go here. As soon as he realizes and presses go. Yeah, I want my Phoenix Hawks. I do. I'd rather be playing a Phoenix Hawk right now. But I just don't have them yet. I gotta wait. I will eventually get a Phoenix Hawk. Eventually. As I alt-tab here, we have 39 people watching. Thank you for showing up. That's awesome. And, just checking my YouTubes and checking my Reddits. Let's see here. One machine gun, 30 tons of ammo. Win combo? What the hell? That's a little ridiculous. Briar would rather be playing a Huntsman. I would too. Huntsman will be great. I can't wait for that thing to come out. What is that, October, I think it is? That's a long time to wait for a Huntsman. At least we know it's actually coming. Frozen City again! Let's see if it wins. I only have one monitor. I have my computer going with my, like, my desktop with my game with one monitor. I actually have my laptop right beside me on the desk with the chat. So as I am sitting here playing in front of the computer with my mic, I am, like, looking to the left with my eyes and reading chat. And I have it, like, scrolled way the hell in, so that chat's really nice and big, so I can actually read it from a distance without having to lean over and look at it. But let's see here, we've got MS on our team, and Fask, whoever that is. No, MS is on the opposing team. And then Headhunters of Davion. So we shall see how this goes. And I hope for a win. I hope for a win. If we don't get a win soon, I'll go back to solo pugging for a while. Then it's more my my own online skill, not having to rely on all of my teammates that I'm put with. Let's see here. Put the UX on the right click with the two, and we'll push forward. And I'm in the same spawn location. I want to spawn on the other side for once. Let's see here. Before, we went this way immediately. Let's go up this way immediately. Now, just to do some variety. Merkstar! That's MS. If I don't ever know the name of a clan, and this is not saying anything bad about any of the clans I run into, I just, for some reason, tend to give them disease names. I don't know why.
Target spotted.
Like, until I learned that it was Merkstar, I just remembered them as multiple sclerosis. I don't know why. I'm so sorry. Don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. It's just, that's what I remembered them. It was easy for me. We're just gonna push right through here. There you go, Phoenix Hawk.
Like,
oh god, don't get in his way.
Negative.
Are we gonna push? Oh no, you're gonna go inside the dropship. Alright, let's try it over here. Oh hey, there's Jenner. Hi, Jenner. Alright, I missed my first two shots. But Jenner put up a UAV, didn't he? Yeah, those missiles It still hit me. There's definitely a UAV. UAV. Enemy UAV over the dropship, please.
Warning, incoming missile.
As we are going for cover.
Those. Incoming missile.
My naming is harsh. I'm so sorry if my naming sounds harsh. I can't. I'm sorry. It was the only way I can remember them is to think of like some humorously named. But now that I know they're Merkstar sometimes, I sometimes remember what MS means. But I forget, there's too many guilds out there, too many clans. Oh, that's a lot of bullets. I'm not going to step up there. Let's try around the right side? I don't know. These guys seem to be having a little bit of luck. We've lost a guy. No! That's no good. Oh, there's an enemy UAV.
They may be moving towards tunnel.
There, got it.
New target acquired.
Oh, there's an enemy right the hell there. A Victor.
New target acquired.
Let's see here. What can we do? What can we do? I have no concept of which way I should go. Ow!
Incoming missile.
Tool Goss. Missiles. Ah, everybody hates me. I'm just not getting into good positions on this map. I just don't know where to go yet. I'm trying to scrape around places, but there's just enemies. Damn it! Things aren't going well. That's for sure.
New target acquired.
Got a little bit of damage out there on the dragon.
Warning, incoming missile.
Got some missiles that we dodged, thankfully. And our team looks like we're rallying and pushing around the right side. So we're going to push with them.
New target acquired.
We're going to get ready here to put some damage out. We got this catapult. Taking them out. Excellent. Going for the awesome. We're just going to continue to push as we come around the right side. We have some opponents up there. We're going to use the ship as a piece of cover. We're going to put some fire downrange. We are quite easily outclassed by that Kodiak, but we shall do the best we can.
New target acquired.
Put some lasers into the Victor. I feel like the Jenner is going to come around our ass.
New target acquired.
Oh, it's a crab. Going for the sides. Nope. It's a standard engine crab. Nope. They're always XL. Why? Ah.
New target.
And I'm down. Ugh. This is not working out.
New target acquired.
Gonna quit out of this match. I'm sorry, Pry. It's just not working out right now. It's patch day. There's too many large groups of really good players out there that are kicking our little two-man's ass. I think I'll just have to go it alone for a while, unfortunately. All right, cut that UAC catapult off, and we're gonna give that a person requested it, so we're gonna go executioner. I think this is my laser bomb executioner. Let's get in there. Person asked if I like Twitch more than YouTube, or like which one I like more. I found that YouTube just works better for me. Like, I could do a Twitch, but I found both my encoding settings to just work a little bit better on YouTube. I was getting a little better picture quality for the amount of data I had to push out. And also, if I just stream on YouTube, I don't have to build up two audiences. So, like, with, like, No Guts, No Galaxy, they stream on Twitch, and they post on YouTube, where they have to have two player bases in that sense. Like, they have to have two audiences. They have to get people to both sub on YouTube and follow on Twitch. And what that means is that you have these situations where you'll have people that are on one, but not on the other, or people that are on both. And if they're on both, you can, like, do the same thing. Like, if they watch the Twitch stream, they're not going to be very interested in watching the video afterwards. But if you have people who are, like, on the other way, they'll watch the video, but they're not going to have the interaction that they see on the video. Like, people who watch these streams later is the entire reason I put the chat in the side of the video. Because if I was just responding to, like, 1/100th of the chat messages or something like that, people wouldn't know what was being discussed. So having the, like, I don't know, just having it all in one spot and having, like, the chat being shown so people can be interacting, really interesting, and I think much better for what I wanted to do, which is why I'm on YouTube. But there you go. That's a very long-winded answer to that. We are in our executioner, our fast online assault, because we have sensors, the
weapons online.
We have the mask, so all we can go, I'm a 90kph assault. Where are we? Okay, we're off on the left flank. Let us push forward here. We're going to get right up there, and that's where we're going to hold for now. We're going to try to use our large pulse lasers to do a little bit of sniping, as we have mask and jump jets, so we're mobile. So we're going to get right up here, and all of our weapons are right mounted, so we...
Wow, we got the infamous Kanajashi with us?
Don't get in my way, you Ebon, but we're going to let him have that side, because he got there first, and I'm walking into walls here. I don't know how infamous I am.
Acquired.
Enemy spotted.
Are you filming this?
I'm live streaming.
There you go, baby.
All right, now we're going to come around the right, the side here. Let out some missiles. Not missiles. New some lasers. Acquired. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore sometimes. But ooh. We're gonna... Enemy spotted!
Target spotted!
New target acquired.
that target spotted is a little difficult to use, but there are enemies on our left. We're just gonna hold right here. We're gonna wait for them to push around. And drain some laser beams into their faces. Acquired. A little bit hot here.
New target
but
acquired.
This is okay. We'll let that one go. We're gonna wait for the next guy.
New target acquired.
That was a much better hit.
So Henry's a Kodiak?
Come on, opponents. Come around that side. Acquired. There's a Pirate's Bane down there. We don't want to really lose this position here, but we will... We can go across. That's something we can do.
New target
and we can
acquired.
Move so that their cover is not useful anymore, and we'll get into a good position right here. And now
new target acquired.
They're out of cover, but I can still be in cover. We can start putting out some serious damage. I hit a cool shot there just to keep myself
new
in the game
acquired.
Keep it firing because
critical.
We want to keep the pressure on. We want
new
to push them out of this zone here because we don't want them right there. We want to get them moving on our terms.
Heat level
another
critical.
Big old hit into whatever
new
that was.
Acquired.
Didn't matter. The big old hit is all that mattered. Because we are pumping out a lot of laser beams.
Target acquired. Target
and he's
destroyed.
Down! Excellent! Now there's a little locust down there. Nothing
target
we can
acquired.
Do about him. He'll be a little difficult to see and shoot, so we're just going to back up here. We have nobody on our left in terms of allies, so we're gonna have to watch that flank. We'll probably move here. We're probably gonna head back over to our old position. I'm gonna get out of here because I'm afraid of enemies flanking around.
New target.
Oh, we
acquired.
Got an opponent there. Did some hits into him before he gets out of range. Yeah, we're just gonna start moving this way. That's where our allies are. We don't want to be left behind. That locust gets behind us, we're screwed. I show that rock what's for. Yeah, yeah. I shoot rocks. They get in the way. I try to shoot enemy mechs all the time, but yes, I shoot some rocks sometimes.
I do
my own fair share of damage. Yeah, so you can see the opponents are moving around that way. I would have been in a little bit of trouble if I had stayed, but thankfully to our jump jets, we can take this maneuverability and we can get around the side here with absolutely no worries. And we're in a much better position now.
New target.
We will
acquired.
Be using this firing lane, and we have basically swapped. We are now in their position, which is awesome. Torso twist that away. We gotta watch that right torso, as that is where all of our weapons are located. We lose the right torso, we are primarily screwed. And oh, that poor Kid Fox took a great big hit. See, much slower battles in the solo queue, much less divisive in terms of enemy mechs getting in there and just killing you. Enemy UAV. Take it out. Excellent.
New target. Oh,
enemy
acquired.
Running around the side here. We're in pretty good cover, so we're just gonna
heat level
give some
critical.
Help there. Help
new
take him out.
Acquired.
And there's this little locust, and I'm just gonna have so much trouble hitting locusts this patch because they are so goddamn tiny. This match is still really new even, although acquired. I know I have done a ton of damage. Let's come on, locust. Come out, run. Oh, come on. Run into the
new
open so I can kill
acquired.
You, please. There you go, not catapult. Kodiak out in the open. Allows me to take his side almost off. I'm just gonna move back behind cover here. As the opponents are moving, we're gonna move to intercept. No! We're losing members. Moving right flank here. We're gonna try to take out whoever is coming around this side. Come on, we gotta get this mass. We gotta get into position here. Come on. There we go.
Target destroyed.
Oh, he's down. Excellent. And I think we've got it. It's 11-8, 12-8. That was a good match. And I'm gonna predict that that's a 1,000 damage game. Because I did a lot of lasering. Oh, 900. So close. It felt strong. Just a little bit low in terms of my prediction. But still, that is an amazing match to get that much damage. Yes, all right, Executioner scratched off my list. I only have 2 left, so you guys gotta start thinking of builds for me to run. As I take another glorious chug of water in between mechs here, because oh, water's so good. Now, the only weapon Jaguar I have right now is a laser Jaguar. You guys kind of just saw another laser game. So let's not open that yet. Let's not do that. What else can we do? You know, the quick draws got shorter and Mad Dogs got really shorter. I feel like I should try the splat dog. I haven't done that in so long. Feel like it could kick some serious ass right now. Kind of like the splat Splatapult, but more clan. Let's see here. Pump this thing full of ammo. I don't want a half ton there, I want a full ton. I can't do things properly. Why am I missing with my ammo? How much ammo do I need here? 600-800 rounds? I do a ton and a half per six. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 something. Yeah, I need a little bit more. 800 rounds is a lot, though. You could drop these down, because you don't really need armor on the arms if you're not going to need your arms. And that gives us another bit of weight here. Just fill it out with ton. Okay, that'll be enough ammo. And then we'll... What arm do I shield with? I shield with my left. We'll armor that one up. Maybe. Do that. Put some heat sinks in there. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I haven't run this build in forever. 27... Oh wow, I had more ammo than the game allowed me. Ass! Or more armor than the game allowed. Let's just do that. 10,000 rounds of SRM. It'll work. Saving. I can't wait until they fix the saving so that it actually, you know, saves in just a second or two instead of taking so long. Supposedly that's entirely fixed. They found the reason why it's not working that well. And they fixed it. Alright, do I have modules? I don't have modules right now. Alright, well. Whoa, that was fast. Bogger manifold. Those would probably work. Probably bog would be my best choice. Canyon's kind of annoying for brawlers. Polar Highlands just impossible for brawlers. Manifold or canyon will probably win though, so bog. Manifold wins. Yes, the mech is like a TNT shed. It's got a whole bunch of death in it. Splat and dog on my list, and then scratched off immediately. It's not going to be chain splat, it's going to be left-right. So it's going to be like the three on the left, the three sixes on the right, and then the three sixes on the left. You know, it's going to be like, boom, boom, one, two, punch. Should be good. We have a tiny bit of armor in our arms, and it's just to absorb a few shots. Now,
reactor online.
Let's see,
online.
Will it actually be correct in the sense that the bottom three are right side and the top three are left side? I hope. We're not going to fire, test fire at all, because we need to get to the center. And oh my god, we can just run in and take Theta. Oh, yes! People can, people have to come to us in Theta, and then we can just kick their ass. Alright, we're gonna throw on heat here because, it's a little hard to see people down here. The lighting isn't that good, so. Come on. There's a shark in the water, and he's waiting for you. I want a little light to pop around that corner and just go, Oh, fuck. And then kill him.
Delta 4.
Oh, we're capturing Theta here. We got a Spirit Bear with us as well. No, doesn't look like anyone's coming down. They were wise to my plan.
Target spotted.
Oh, well. All right, let's back out of here. And, see what we can do here. Where's that Kodiak? He's actually, like... Oh!
Target acquired.
Come on in!
Warning incoming.
Oh, you're a streak one.
Right arm, critical damage.
Alfred!
Right arm destroyed. Heat sink destroyed. Left arm critical damage.
Yeah. I'm just a better build than you.
Destroyed.
Delta down.
Ate that guy up. He did a fair amount of damage to me. They can shoot out a ton of missiles.
Please separate your microphone from your speakers.
He was not the right mech for the short range. Let's cross here. See if there's anybody outside. Ooh, there's somebody dropping down.
Acquired.
I like what me and this Kodiak are doing.
New target acquired. Target destroyed.
Nice shot, good job.
I love it.
Target acquired.
It makes me happy. Oh, that's enemies.
Right side is clear, Delta 5.
Lots are coming downstairs with us.
New target acquired.
Delta 4, Delta 5.
Level critical.
We're gonna override here.
Override engage.
Yeah, a whole bunch of pushing downstairs.
Target destroyed. New target acquired.
Oh man. So happy I'm in Splat Dog right now.
Target Lima.
New target acquired.
Alright, we're gonna go out in a blaze of glory. I kill myself. Oh, 717 damage. Out of nowhere. But yeah. Yeah, like all of them pushed underneath.
New target.
We managed to do a fair amount of damage before they got us.
Artillery.
But wow,
online.
That was
I'll go cat.
An intense little fight there.
Target.
As we watch our catapult here, small lasers and tens. That might be another build to try. We are seeing all of the catapults come out of the woodwork. Which is awesome. I love seeing that. It's being popped, fixed tomorrow. Don't worry.
Target
oh,
destroyed.
Alarm awesome.
New target acquired.
That's painful.
Target acquired.
But it looks like we're gonna win this match, which makes me happy. Is this the first one I've had this evening? I think it is. Because
new target.
Yeah, I don't know. Matches were just going a little bit difficult in group
target
queue.
Destroyed.
And what's left in solo queue is all of the people who are just gonna derp around.
Nice job,
and that's
doctor.
Perfect when I'm wanting to just make a commentary and not really care about how well I'm playing. Let's see the results here. Yes! All the C-bills! 449,000. Because we just ripped the hell. It's all these component destroyed and brawlings. Like, look at component destroyed. Another 32,000. The win was 35. So, just... nice. Kill assists. Conquest bonus is great as well. Also, the solo kill and the brawling are very nice bonuses. And everything gets multiplied to 90%. Bonus right now. I think it is. Is it 90? Because premium time is 50, heroes 30, And yeah, this is 10, so 90% bonus. So good. And now that we've had some fun with splat, let's go back to some sort of meta lasers. We have a question in the chat: how much is premium? Premium time is dependent on how much you buy in MC. You can actually go to the MechWarrior store as well, though. So I can't remember what it was. I think I did a calculation, and I think for if you're just going to buy like a day or two at a time, it's really bad in terms of the how much dollars per day you put in. If you buy a year premium, it's less than a dollar a day, but that's investing a whole bunch of money into at once. I'd say the best bang for your buck is 30 days of premium. And if I alt-tab here, I can go check how much exactly that is in the store. If you go to the gift store, when that's gifting it to somebody else. So don't buy your own premium time through this. But, or I guess you can, because you can just put in the code into your own account. But 30 days is $12 USD. I've graphed the amount of dollars in to the amount of days out for premium, and you start getting the best bang for your buck around 30 days. Why you gotta kill my poor ass? I'm so sorry. Did I kill you in the last game? Oh, I'm sorry. I can't help it. I just gotta shoot the opponents. So best bang for your buck is 30 days, which is 12 USD in the gift store, and can't remember how many MC it is, but it's around $12 in terms of value. Let me just cancel out of searching here. Go to the store, go to premium time, which is boosters. It's 2,500. Okay, so 2,500. Now the question is, how much MC is 2,500? So I'm just going to log into one of my accounts here and go to the MC purchase page. You can get 3,000 for $15. You'll have 500 left over. So that's some of the problems, is that you can get it for $12 from the gift store and then apply that to your account. Or you can buy $15 of gold, basically, the MC, spend 2,500 on 30 days, and have 500 left over for getting one-shot camel patterns, which is the best bang for your buck in terms of the rest of that money. So you can one-shot camel patterns and converting a little bit of XP if you want that. So I would say if you want to do a tiny bit of investment, you can get that 30 days. But, you can also get packages. So if you like go to the store here, and I'm just looking at it, say you want a specific mech. Like say, oh hey, I just want to get Warhammers. If you buy a standard pack of Warhammers, you get 30 days of premium time, which is like the $12 value, the $15 value, that sort of thing. You don't get any extra MC, so you can't do any stuff like that. But you also get several heavies. So if you know which mech you want to get, these $20 packages are actually a really good deal, because it's like $12 value of premium time as well as the mechs, which are more expensive than $20 if you were to buy them with MC. So it's all up to you want. If you want to get a specific one of the $20 packages, they're a really good deal. Or if you don't want one of them, get $15 of MC, get 30 days of premium time, and have a little bit left over for customization. That's sort of my my recommendation, which was a little long-winded, but it worked out. And people are still complaining about the minimap. It's being patched tomorrow, 5 p.m. Come on, people. Follow Twitter. Really easy to find out. We are for the first time on the other side. See where
target acquired.
These things. Oh, there we go. We got an opponent over there. They some guys moving to our left flank.
Looks like it. I can't tell.
Target spotted.
Use the good old Mark One eyeballs. Can't rely on your instruments.
New target acquired.
Target spotted.
But yes. Actually, one of the best investments I ever made in this game is a year of premium time. Like, if you were like, oh man, I love this game, and I'm gonna play it for a whole lot of time, get some premium time for a year. I mean, actually, well, because I get every single mech pack for my work with NGNG as like my compensation for doing work for them, I have like 400 something days of premium active right now, which is ridiculous. But yeah, when I was back as my own private person, I didn't have any connections. I was paying for everything myself. A year of premium time was one of my best decisions. It got me so much further along in the game than not having it. Yeah, they're continuing to push around our left flank. Right up beside the ice wall. As we are getting pushed in here, I want to back up a little bit. Alright, flip around this wall here. The 10% of the tourney pack thing is really nice, but every day that goes by, it's getting less and less valuable because the tourney pack only lasts until December 3rd. Ooh, that's a Kodiak. I don't want that. I don't want that. Let me get out of here. I'm walking into walls because I can't see my legs orientation. Get another good hit to that guy. This is an interesting battle because I've never fought in this city before, so I don't know the angles yet. Ooh, Kodiak. He's down. Excellent. Still feel like enemies are coming around our left flank. Yes, they are. Yeah, they're pushing hard left. Pushing hard left. We are in position to attack them back, though. Got a good hit in there. We're going to hook around. We're going to push forward. Forward into the opponents. We CT'd that guy. We're going to shoot him once more. He's down. Excellent. Push around the side. Pop my cool shot. I need to keep shooting. Mech down. I need shield, shield, shield. Get back in behind the building. Wait for my allies to take the attention of the enemies. And then I can pop back out. Put another shot in. Get back into cover right before I die. I am going to die very closely here. Very quickly, but I will take another down before I do. We are good. We're going to come around the side here because I feel like the opponents are, again, hooking around our left flank. They seem to be going that way. We're going to try to push into the rears as we are super duper crit. We're going to take this Marauder here as a tank for us. And we're going to try to drop this Phoenix Hawk as he comes around. One more hit to the Phoenix. He's down. Oh god. I'm so crit. I'm sorry. I'm unable to read chat right now because things are going crazy. I will read when I get back. I'm focusing. But we're gonna win! As we've got our opponents running away. But no, I'm so crit, I could die from anything. As the Phoenix Hawk and Black Knight are running along down there, and they get taken out. Alright. I don't know if I should buy the $70 Knight gear. Let me just go back and chat here a little bit. I don't know if I should buy the $70 Knight gear, or 20 to Hero, or the 40 plus Hero. I want all options available. Yeah, I think that the Knight gear will be a very strong mech. It'll be a little bit slow. I dislike slow heavies. I prefer my heavies to have some good mobility. But yeah. Oh, you're in this game again, Lord. Nice. You took the bullet for me, man. Thank you so much. I greatly appreciate it. As we scratch Ebon Jaguar off the list. And I'm going to go into my PPC Nova. As I still don't have my Phoenix Hawks. Urgh. Not enough Phoenix Hawks for me. I can't... Oh. My dropship will probably arrive in a couple days. So when I do my Friday night stream, which is going to become like a guaranteed thing, every Friday night I'm going to stream, I'll probably have my Phoenix Hawks by then. And then I'll be doing my Phoenix Hawks. But yeah, I think the Knight gear will be nice. It's just going to be a bit slow. It's the only problem with it. It's going to have a crap ton of weapons, though. So, yeah, I don't know. It won't be able to change its engine, which is really unfortunate. Like, it couldn't have the opportunity to be, like, the Black Knight for the clans, in that sense. But... just not going to. Any chance for Orion 2C? Sure. Orion 2C on the list. There's always a chance for every chassis that I own. Do-do-do-do-do. Speaking of some things here, I actually have a list of mech build videos I'm going to be doing soon, because I literally have 2 episodes of Dark Souls left. I have one uploaded, the Pent Ultimate episode, and then I have the finale to record. And then I'm done Dark Souls, which is awesome, because then I don't feel like I have to be pushing that show anymore. I can do some more mech stuff. So MechWarrior 4 Vengeance will start, and the great thing about that is it's a nice single player game. I can just sit down on a weekend and just like play for 6 hours and make like a dozen episodes and then have content for a month, you know, that sort of feeling. I don't care, any of these maps work for me. But I'm going to be doing some more mech build videos, and I'm going to probably, I don't know the order, but I'm going to do these. I'm going to do that 6 medium pulse Jester that I showed earlier on the stream. I'm going to do the 3 UAC 5 Jaeger mech, the 4 SRM 6 Adder, probably also do the 6 SRM 6 Mad Dog or the Splat Cat. I'm not sure. So, Splat Dog or Splat Cat or Splatter. Some kind of splat video. I don't want to do Stormcrow Splat, because I do that on my free-to-play. I also want to do the Spirit Bear. And, I want to do the, like, 4 or 5 large laser Battlemaster. Should be good. Online. So those are all sensors mech build online. Videos I want to pump out weapons in the next, like, online. Month. All systems nominal. All right. Pow pow! Do you have any videos that can teach me not to suck in a Timberwolf? Well, not in any particular mechs, but... you know... you just... gotta get good. No, I'm just not gonna say that. You gotta kick some butt in a Timberwolf, because it's gotta play to its strengths. Timberwolves are really mobile for a 75-tonner. They're not gonna have as much payload as a Black Knight or stuff like that, because the Black Knights can change their engines and such like that. So you're just gonna have to compensate by using that mobility, using that torso twist, using those jump jets. Some really good builds on them are the Gauss in the right torso, ER Med, and two large Pulse in the left, like the Alpha left torso. That's really good. Then that you do that on the SCT, because then you can have that single jump jet in the CT. Oh, man, I thought he was going to drop down. Yeah, I was waiting for that. Come on. I want you to peek out underneath. Ah, just missed him. Oh well. Okay, let's continue with our team. We're getting left behind. We gotta hook right really fast here. Our team's pushing right, and we gotta move right as well. Otherwise, we're gonna be left behind, and we'll get eaten by Jenners and Arctic Cheetahs and shit like that. Just push. Push. It's a Lerm crab. No, nothing to be worried about. Oh,
new target.
Thunder. Pump that into the Thunderbolt. Top Dog. They lose some of their quirks this time, so less afraid of Top Dogs now. Do a little Pop-Tarties. Get back into cover. I have to step less into cover, as I am much shorter now.
Critical.
We'll give myself a second here to cool. And then we'll pop one. Oh, he just fell enough that I was not able to hit him. Ah, goddammit. They're getting away. They're getting away!
New target.
That's alright. We'll change top here. Change targets.
New target acquired.
Let's push up. Took off his arm. Excellent. A lot of his stuff is gone. That rock is in a bad position.
Acquired.
Put some shots into that crab. He is not getting away. We will finish the rock. What? How could he live through that? I don't know. But he is alive still. We're going to continue to push around.
Target acquired.
As we are losing allies. No! We got a crab moving up. Not really afraid of the crab very much, because a lot of his weight is being lost with Lerms. And, ooh, he's cooking.
Critical.
He was cooking from ammo explosions.
Critical.
Nope, missed that. Brought it back to 4-4. I think if several of them are underneath, actually. Although I'm not sure. I missed where they went. We're just going to get back on top, because... yeah. You know what is something I want them to do for April Fools? Is set the T-scale. Which T-scale is a setting in the CryEngine that shows how, like... fast the game runs.
Target
I want
acquired.
Them to set the T scale to like 3. So new everything is moving acquired. 3 times faster than normal. Ah, just
fuel
hit the pillar.
At 25%.
Oop, there's some opponents.
New target acquired.
Come on.
New target acquired.
Put some PPCs in. Get back around cover.
New target acquired.
Ah, just missing the Direwolf. There we go.
Damage. Critical.
Critical. That guy's back behind cover. No need for me to shoot at him anymore.
New target acquired.
We got a Warhammer here. I'll do little jump snipes. Pop that cool shot. We need to keep fighting. Our allies need us. Put up some good shots. Oh, we missed him. Me trying to do flick shots. It's not working.
Target destroyed. New target acquired.
Take a nice big jump here. Can I see anyone from across the map? Nope.
Fuel at 0%.
Alright, let's get back over to where our allies need us. As we can see the low signal.
Target destroyed. Target acquired.
There you are.
Acquired.
Come on. Down.
New target acquired.
It's that little bitty locust down there. It's gonna have to take a little bit of PPCs up the butt. Yeah, little bitty locust. I'm sour, but my PPCs are wanting your buttocks. Oh my god, those good things are so fast, so small. Just like me, no. I kid. Ugh, but at least I have jump jets. Makes life so much easier. Oh, what is that? Is that the direwolf? Wow, the direwolf over there is still up. Oh, here he comes. Oh, I just missed him. One more try. Ah, yes! Yes! I legged him! Woo!
Target destroyed.
No locust legs, get away from me.
Target acquired.
And we just gotta push the direwolf. This guy won't have any idea what's coming. Jump! Fly through the air with the greatest of ease.
Destroy.
For I am Nova!
Critical.
Yes! He is down.
Oos, oos, oos.
Nova ERPPC has won me another match because it's awesome. Just the satisfaction you get from blowing off a leg on a Nova. Not Nova. I don't know what I'm saying. On the frickin' locusts. Wow. It's the only locust on the team. That guy had a good match. Oh, wow. Good game for him. But yeah. We do Orion 2C next, because that's what people wanted. But man, I love this thing. It's so much nicer now that it's smaller. Although I fully expect it to lose almost all of its structure quirks in the future. But yeah, Orion 2C, because the Orions actually got buffed. The Orion 2Cs at least. They got some durability because they were actually having some trouble with staying alive. But this is my Orion 2C build. It's got an XL350 because I like the mobility. It's got an Ultra 20, two large pulse, and a medium laser. And I find it's pretty good. It's a good sort of standoff mech. The Ultra 20 gives you some really good short-range combat, while the large pulses with the medium laser gives you a little bit of medium range that makes it a nice ballistic brawler in that sense. I am going to hit this thing to quick play, and I'm going to pop off to the washroom, and hopefully I am back in time for this thing to not be a match starting immediately. floating in here to Forest Colony. It was when I walked away, did it go insta-match? I'm pretty sure it did, didn't it? Always does that. If I have to walk away, or my phone rings, or the doorbell rings, insta-match. Damn it. But when I'm sitting here going, I need one more match before, like, ceasefire, or one more match before this event ends, or something like that, it, goes... takes hours. But oh well.
Reactor
online. It went insta-match.
Sensors online. Weapons.
Want to take out the Thunderbolt 9S post-scale and retry the PPC sniper build. I like to call that one the Thunderball. It is a good mech. I used it quite extensively with my Grow to CW. It was probably one of the all-stars. I thought the 5SS was going to be the all-stars, but the Thunderball turned out to be the real all-star. That high-mounted double ERPPCs, especially back then when it had stupidly high minus energy on the energy heat reduction. Oh my god, so good.
Thanks, negative.
Hitler did nothing wrong, okay. Let us move forward here. I want to go and see the new passageway in D5.
Thanks.
As we spam, thank you. Let's see where our Nova is taking us. I am behind you, Mr. Nova. I shall leave a little bit of space because we don't, we want to make sure that he can back up if needed be. But as he moves forward, I will move forward as well. We're probably going to go around the side here. One thing I can say about this, the enemy spotted should be right in the center, so that you can just tappy when you see an enemy. Much easier. Again, the... haven't actually tried out Forest Colony so far. Yeah, we'll try a Warhawk. I can do that.
Target acquired.
Oh. Enemy is pushing around that side. Let's try to hook right here.
Yeah. Base is being captured.
Ooh, base being captured. That's interesting. Firing off some guys there. Got to lead your shots a little bit with the Ultra 20. We're just going to allow ourselves to cool off.
Left side arch of East 5. Left side arch of East 5.
New target acquired.
Come around the side here. Put in some nice hits. That's what this thing likes to do. It likes to come around the side, just volley, and then get back into assist. Like, get back into cover. One bad thing I have, when I'm just talking off the cuff of my head here. Like, speaking off the cuff, whenever I see a word as I'm talking, I'll for some reason like slip it into where I'm supposed to be saying a different word. So like, I was gonna say off the cuff or off the cusp of my mouth or lips or something like that, but the person had assistance in the chat and so I read assistance instead, and I was just like, god damn it. It's just a problem I have. Oh god.
Critical damage. Heat sink destroyed.
Ooh, that took a bunch of damage. We're not gonna get in this guy's way as he backs up here. That Zeus gets owned. We are up 3 kills. which is excellent. I'm going to try to push around this right side. My left side armor is the one that's taking the damage. Oh, and we dropped that guy. So nice. One more base being captured, but we are in an entire lance. One mech out in the water.
Target spotted.
And, okay, let's try to push up a little bit here.
New target acquired.
Ooh. Oh. There goes my left torso. Although I only lost one of my guns. So I'm still fairly into the fight here.
New target acquired. New target acquired. Center torso critical.
CT took some hits, but that Evan Jaguar CT is quite low. But I'm probably going to go down here, try to shield with my right side, try to get back into cover. I just have my Ultra 20 left. And, yeah, that's it for me in terms of lasers for this match. I am a one-hit kill. See if I can take anybody out with me as I move around the side. I still got to keep on that the heat vision because I just can't see opponents without them. Oh, I'll try without it for a bit.
Target destroyed.
Although I feel like this match is target now over. Acquired. My allies just mopping acquired. Everybody up. So let's take a look at chat. I will try the Warhawk. I added onto my list here. Warhawk. As I write it down and walk my mech into a wall.
Base is being captured.
And base is being captured. They really like trying to capture our base. It probably screwed it up for them as I walk into more walls because I'm looking at chat. So, I will not get back there in time in order to assist in the base defense. At least I don't think I will. La 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 la. Fire some shots out into the air. Yes, it is. Staying alive is a good thing to try to do.
New target. Oh, wow. Acquired.
No. Oh, I was hoping I could hit one of those.
Target destroyed.
A little bit
new
too far
acquired.
For the shot. But two more, the Oxide
new
and the
acquired.
Stormcrow. And we win. See, I get back into solo queue and I start kicking ass. So probably without the structure quirks that came out in this patch, I would have died in this match. Just so you know. Just joined, how's the patch? The patch is a really good patch with a blemish on it. And that's it. The blemish is being removed tomorrow. And then it's just going to be a really good patch. What do we got here? Alerts. Friend requests. Cattlemen. Just regular old random peoples. That's the Orion 2C. Nice ballistics and lasers and Warhawk time. Warhawk Prime. I have the 2 ERPPC Gauss rifle build on this. I'll give it a try. Nice long range. A little different from what we've seen before so far this evening. And we are in the last half hour of the stream. We've been going since just before 6 o'clock. It has now been 2 hours. I'm going to go until just before 8:30 and call the stream there because I need to get some breakfast. I can't think anymore. I need to get some dinner. I'm hungry. But we're going to do a few more matches. Is the Warhawk searches away. I alt-tab to see how many people we have. 44 people watching now. That is awesome. 45 people watching. Really interesting that you guys want to hear what I have to say. I like it. Also, my subscriber count has been going crazy. I mean, like, just last week, I hit 3,000 and that was a huge thing. And now I'm almost at like 3,200. It's just skyrocketing. We'll go Frozen City because we have a nice long-range hop build, and it's a nice, actually, semi-long-range cold map, which is perfect for us. And thankfully for the Warhawk, it's not like Polar Highlands, where a lot of the attacking is going over a ridge, where things like the Stalker and the Kodiak and stuff like that are really good because they're high mounted hardpoints. In this map, you can go around the side of a lot of stuff, which is very good for mechs like the Warhawk, because they have the wide arms, so you can just barely peek around the side and plunk in a pair of ERPPCs into somebody. You've never played the game, you're watching to learn. Well, welcome to the game. This is Mech Warrior Online. I am one of the new player helping focused guys out there. I have a list of videos, a playlist, if I can use my words correctly, just a whole bunch of tutorials on how to play the game, or just watch stream because I talk about my tactics, or watch the Road to Community Warfare as I play through that. But that is an old one. There's also the Steam Free to Play, which is more edutainment, if I want to say that correctly. It's educational and it's entertainment. Let's move forward here. So, in every single map, every single time, people are talking about minimap. Fun once you get a mech you own, that is true, and a mech that you enjoy owning. I know some people who have started off and been like, well, I'm gonna go buy a Locust because that looks fun. And then they're just like, well, that sucked because I died almost instantly. You gotta find a mech you like. We plug some shots into that Jaeger, get him to turn away, go, oh god, I don't want to see that. It's so much more energetic on live stream. I know, I actually really enjoy it. It's a really fun way for me to interact with people. I just tend to go like, woohoo! Happy mix! Oh no, I shot the over top of the freaking Black Knight. Or was that Blackjack? But this Nova will suck my big Warhawk cock. Okay, woo! Oh god, I'm getting hit from the side. Let's push around the right a little bit. Hit him hard. Wow, this is really interesting fight over Theta. We'll just derp that into the Nova. He is CT crit. Whoa! Blackjack close, Blackjack goes. Put that shot into his back. That should be enough. We're going to allow our allies to take care of him as we start to focus again back on the front, because we're an assault. We don't want to be chasing around the guys that are flanking us. We want to be focusing on the front lines where the enemies are and putting out good shots into the opponents at long range like that, keeping their heads down. But we'll see where our team is going here. Ooh, that's a Jaeger. Put a shot into him and give him our side as fast as we can. He is running the dual 20 builds. We're going to pull a little bit more range from him then, as we don't want to get that close to that mech.
New target acquired.
Pull around the side here. Put a shot in. Shield the return. It's a Jaeger mech.
New target acquired.
With Gauss and large laser. It's a pretty standard build for the Firebrand. Ooh, enemy you have. Multiple enemy you have. Alright, take a second here. Drop that one. And wait for the PPCs to recharge. And drop it again. Oh, well, I got that one. Just missed the PPCs.
Critical damage.
And unfortunately, my arm's getting attacked here. Come on. Just poke back out, because you think I've fired. And put in another good shot.
Acquired.
Now, The enemies are capping us out. Oh, no, they're right behind me, aren't they? Yeah. Unfortunately, they have circled around us. We are not... doesn't look like we're winning this one very well. I've just been... I've just been stripped. Nothing I can do about that. You can't win every match. I did a decent amount of the damage, but... oh well. Should quit out of that match because it's not as entertaining as when I'm playing if I'm just watching other people. You don't like how the rescale combines with some of the quirk changes and a couple of mechs that really did not need to be changed. Yeah, there are some mechs that are out there just like, what? But even from like the pixel counts and stuff like that that have been going around in the community, like the lights, that's what a lot of people are mentioning, like the spiders and the Jenners and the Firestarters and the Panthers and stuff like that. And the Wolfhounds are so much taller. It is a little frustrating. Definitely there'll be a pass on quirks in the next patch, I'd say. I would guess. Because they're not going to take all this rescaling lying down, in that sense. They're going to go through and see how things go for after the rescaling, and I wouldn't be surprised at all if basically catapults lost their durability in total. Like, they were brought down a little bit, but they probably didn't realize the catapult was going to be, like, so tiny, so good at spreading damage now, so... that's probably one thing. Should I try taking out some of my dragons? Large laser, AC-10, AC-20, 4 meds. What do I have on this thing? I have a standard 300, AC-20, and 4 medium lasers. That's actually very close to what I have on my rifleman here. It's actually exactly the same. So, very, close builds there, but it may be interesting to get rid of that. It may be interesting to see how the dragon does now that it's much smaller. We'll give it a try. Man, the flame used to be my ride. Back when the dragon first came out, there was no heat scaling. I used to run 4 ER large laser flame, and used to just have massive XL engine. Back when kit detection was shitty, and just run constantly, and ER large laser people from so far away. You want a Zeus, old favorite. Well, good to know that, because Zeuses are in the game. You can pick one up. So, you can play your old favorite mechs as they continue to add them. Whether, well, I mean, it's great that they're adding them. It's kind of annoying it's always in a, you know, buy a mech pack. But that's how they have to make their money. YouTube stream is pretty good. Glad you like it. I specifically settled on 720p because I could have a higher quality image in 720 than other stuff. Let's see here. I'm going to vote for River City because I know it's not going to win against Frozen City. And... oh, whoa, oh, terrible Therma. What? Oh, wow, that was close. That was close. We almost had terrible Therma. Let's see here. 8-12. Probably another one or two matches. What's wrong with the minimap? It's, you'll see it in-game here. That's all I can say. Oh, there's a full post on the forums. Ooh, I have to read that. I definitely... It's like, when I go streaming, I get into a little bit of a vacuum for a few hours. So, if there's any, like, new developments, I can't comment on them until I get out of the stream, because I'm not gonna, like, take my time mid-stream and stop and then read the posts and stuff like that. Yeah, it'd just be silly. Anyway. Minimap is being fixed. We don't have to worry about it anymore. As we try out our dragon. Now, the goal of this dragon is got AC-20 and 4 med lasers. We're trying to get close. We're trying to use our mobility and try to just run up and go, surprise, AC-20. We're going to have to use that effectively here. We're on an assault, so... We're going to have to flank. I think we're going to have to go to the north here. So if you look at here, a lot of the battling's been happening here. I think we're going to have to go up here and try to hook ourselves around and try to get around. Or, as soon as I can bring a map again, we'll go down around the south. Basically, I'm going to have to flank. Yeah, Molten Metal. He's a really good guy. I really like his channel. We're starting here. Okay. Enemy's base is there. Our base is there. I'm guessing the enemies start along here. I think we're going to go and we're going to hook this way. Give that a try. Because we actually don't have much ammo for the AC-20. We've only got 21 rounds. And it's not like I'm super duper fast in this dragon. It's got 87.1 kph. And, I mean, that's okay for a heavy. It could be faster. Like, but the reason I'm doing that is because then I get the standard 300, where that way, if I lose a side, I'm not dead, because people think, oh, it's a dragon. It's guaranteed to have an XL engine, so they try to side torso me. Where I'm hedging that bet, they're going to do that, so I get the extra bonus durability, because... they're trying to side torso me instead of trying to CT me. Because if they knew I had a standard, they'd try to CT me. Yeah, it's mind games, man. Mind games. Although I really wish that they had the light engine in this game, so that I could get a little bit more engine out of this while maintaining my ability to lose a side and not die. They would basically work like clan engines. Online. Not give as much weight reduction as an XL, but keep you alive if you lost a side torso.
New target acquired.
Target spotted.
We got some opponents coming forward. Ooh, that summoner might be coming right to us. He is a CIRM summoner. Ooh, enemy UAVs. Multiple over their group. Stop up here. Try to take them down. Ah, we get splatted.
New target acquired.
Ooh, this is not looking good. The enemy seems to be kicking our tail. Put a nice shot there, but that's a Kodiak. Kodiaks win everything.
Left torso critical down.
Oh, and there goes my AC-20. Wow, this is a very bad game so far. Yeah, we're gonna lose this. The sad thing is I can call that from here. Is I know that basically I'm ineffective. And I can tell just by the positioning of the teams, we're guaranteed to lose this match. So, and you see, he shot for the torso, because he thought I'd be an XL engine.
Medium torso destroyed.
Oh well. This match is over. I'm just gonna stand still.
Right arm destroyed.
Come on guys, come kill me. Nothing I can do here. And out. You know, that just happens sometimes. You just get screwed over. You lose your big gun early, you're out of position, your entire team's out of position, and the enemy's just pushing as a nice organized group and just ruffle snap you. nothing you can do about it. You just gotta move on. No sense in getting annoyed by it. But let us try going back to the K2, because we did not get to play very good matches with it while we were in a group, because all of the group queue is just full of people. Tonight, full of really strong pilots, and we got our asses kicked. So we're going to see how good the K2 does on its own. We got the 4 medium laser, 2 UAC 5 build on it right now. You'll see how that does, and maybe change it up once, and then we'll call it a night. Kind of want to do the dual 20s on it. That's fun. Dual Gauss rifle. That's very fun. Because you can see here on the right, the ballistics are now like in line with the cockpit. So dual Gauss would be pretty nice. You wouldn't have to expose much of the mech. As soon as you can see the opponents, you can shoot them. It would work out quite nicely. Domination's okay on this match. Domination sucks on Crimson Strait if you're the team that spawns away from the point. And Cyclops is an assault, as Kevin has answered. So, Crimson Strait domination, 50% of the chance that we're going to hate our lives. See you around, Dark. It's dinner time for you, and it's going to be dinner time for me in 20 minutes. I believe there's some wonderful stir fry waiting for me upstairs. It's just getting cold. I'll have to microwave it. Let's see. Are we sad or are we happy? It all depends on our spawn point. We are sad. Because, yeah, this is a very bad spawn. As soon as the map is available, I'll show you why this is a bad spawn. Man, I was taking down these brambles last weekend that we ripped out of the garden. And I got these scratches all over my arm from it.
Reactor online. Sensors online. Weapons online.
Alright. So, we get ourselves moving here. And then I'll open up the map and show you why this sucks balls. As soon as I get myself on a nice pathway. Right down
here.
So, the teams that spawn here, we have to come this way. Everybody spawns here, they can just go right into it, they can get up top, it's really easy, happy. We have to either rush the saddle, which is kind of suicidal, or we have to push this way and get underneath, because our going up top here is with only a tiny little ramp, and so we can only go one at a time, and we get shot down, so we have to go underneath in order to get into it. It's just like, ugh. So bad for this team, the spawn. They should make us spawn a little bit closer so that the two teams are arriving at the circle at the exact same time. But unfortunately, they don't. So we gotta cope with that. We're pushing underneath because we have to. We need to get into the range. Alright.
That's right, it used to show everything on the mini map.
It's getting fixed tomorrow evening.
I got 6 of those damn seismics.
I doubt it. They're still gonna be fucking up the ass just tomorrow evening. They're gonna put a little bit of rusty lube on it.
There's a forum post that says everything they're gonna change back.
Oh, thank God. What on
earth? Take out this Phoenix Hawk.
This should do it a bit more raw off.
This guy's just like, oh my god! The catapults are killing me! That's a different Phoenix Hawk. This one's more ballsy. The other one ran off that way. Oh, this one's running too. Yeah. Yeah, you're running. Oh, this mech works what it does. Wow, I have no teammates here. Why are they running? I have no teammates here. Oh, hi. Get into cover. Wow, he's CT. Let's go kill him. I feel confident I'd be able to CT this guy. Oh, never mind, he's already dead.
New target acquired.
Damn, my torso weapons. I can't get them high enough. Okay, yes, please come down to me. Thank you.
Target destroyed.
He's down.
New target acquired.
That's somebody shooting me in the back. Let's get down. Oh wow, that Black Knight's really low. I could have killed him.
Target.
Oh, he is dead. Wow.
New target acquired.
I'm not having very many kills this game, but a lot of assists and shit. Right,
did we get them all to the basement?
We are up a whole lance.
Yeah,
that is nice.
Let's clear them up top. Hop down right away.
New target acquired.
Push forward here. We got a little bit of gun depression. We will use that to shoot down at the King Crab. Oh god, both guns are jammed up. That's it. Yeah. Yeah, ballistics. Drop that guy. You know what would be awesome for the catapult K2? Would be a UAC jam chance quirk. Oh man, that would be amazing on this mech. We pick that side torso off.
Acquired.
And
target destroyed.
Took off his arm.
New target acquired.
Kodiak backs. I like Kodiak backs. They're tasty.
Target destroyed.
Oh, I destroyed an ally's arm.
One left.
That worked out well.
Oh shit, he's on the red island, I think.
Oh, he's out there? Oh, there he is.
Acquired.
Fucking
shit. Target destroyed.
Nah, he's dead.
Good run.
Somebody got him.
Good game,
guys. Yeah, it was a good match. So yeah, this thing can do some pretty good damage. I would say that this design would be really good on the K2 if they gave it the UAC jam chance quirk. That would be like, oh, so good. Let's see what else is going on. Oh, stretch my back. I like big backs, and I cannot lie. No, I gotta make that into a Mech Warrior song. I do. I love it when I got like some bear butts. You do the Sir Mix-a-Lot bear butt thing. Hey, Brian Locke. Oh, are you just showing up now? Because unfortunately, I think I'm gonna be ending the stream soon, as I have been going for 2.5 hours. Yeah, man. If this got the 30% UAC jam chance, this thing would be amazing. This 4 medium laser 2 UAC 2 build, it has something like with the Delta Delta that has the UAC jam chance and 3 UAC 5s. It's so strong. But Antonine, oh no! You finally get to catch the stream, and unfortunately I'm just about to end. But I will do one more match, just because you showed up. This will be the final match. And I'll do it in my Jester. This is the last match of the stream. And then I'm off to go get some dinner. I'm hungry. Alt-tab here. And got 44 people watching. Very nice. Of our reduced jam chance module. That would be interesting. You'd have to worry about mechs that already had jam chance reduction. Forest Colony. Frozen City's gonna win. Might as well. It's not. We're gonna play Grim Plexus. What a concept. You'd have to worry about if mechs already had like minus 30 and you could get a jam chance module that was like another minus 10 or minus 20 or whatever it would be. I think 10% is where they cap out a lot of the modules, because like it's range 10% and it's cooldown 12%. I'll do one more match, last match of the stream, 20 matches later. Yeah, I sometimes do that. You just want to make sure that mechs that already had it couldn't go crazy with it. So you wouldn't want to be like an extra 10%, you know, so the Jaeger mech Delta would get 40% reduction. Maybe if the Delta was then dropped to 20% and they added that module in, so it could get its 30%, but then other mechs could have 10%. That would be cool. Jam chance is one of the things I'd like to see modules of. Heat gen and shell velocity would be cool too. I think every soft attribute of the gun should be modulable. When I say soft, I mean all of the things that aren't damage, basically. So, range, cooldown, velocity, heat gen, duration, all that kind of stuff. The only thing that should not be changeable is pure damage. Because if you had, like, plus 10% damage modules, it would just be that, across the line. Like, lasers would be damage and range and heat gen. Those would be the top three. And then ballistics would be damage, velocity. That would be the top two. Maybe then cooldown. Those would be the top three for ballistics. Missiles would be velocity, damage, and cooldown. Yeah, that's the only thing that the only attribute of a gun that I don't think they should change is the actual damage of it. But we're moving forward here with our Jester, our 94 kilometer an hour catapult, who is acting like a great big fat medium, but not so fat actually. Because, it's pretty small now, considering I'm shorter than a lot of mediums. But, I have no idea where the opponents are. Where are our allies going? We have some guys over on the right side, but that's just our light lance. So, I'm gonna go with our heavies and mediums this way. Take it to the left. As we got some opponents over there. Yep. They're over in that complex, as we hear our radar deprivation click off there.
Target.
Let's push forward. Tuck right up in here. And we're looking to catch some enemy mechs. Ooh, there goes my hyper
acquired.
Set up AMSs. We got the enemy lights over here. Let's hook around the side. Whoa. Hi, okay.
Warning incoming.
Yeah, let's get back in cover.
New target acquired.
Ah, shot over his head. I'm in a bad position here, but I think I can rectify it if I come around this side. Can't see where the opponents are, but I can try. We got got some enemies shooting around there. Do some little tickles with our medium pulse. Let's continue around the left side here. It looks like our allies are pushing. Trying to reposition quickly, as that is what this mech is for. At least this design.
New target acquired.
Let's see here. I'm just not getting any good angles.
Target destroyed.
Oop, drop down. I was able to dodge that ERPPC. Those Phoenix Hawks are liking to jump around a corner, eh? So I see them do that a lot. Let's try to push up this way.
New target acquired.
Is that an IV-4 right there? Here he comes. Good, we got a good hit on him. I'm gonna go for the side torso. Alright, he's trying to push us, but we take him down. Because we go right through that side torso. I had predicted that he was an XL engine. But it turned out to be correct.
Target acquired.
Kind of don't like poking around right sides right now because my right torso is open. Whoa, whoa, where is that coming from? Oh! Where did that come from? Wow! It was Ultra 5s that ripped me up. Clan Ultra 5s. No idea where that came from. But, eh, it doesn't look good for our team. Looks like we might be losing that match, but whatever. So, unfortunately, we're going to end on a little bit of a sour note because we got our asses kicked in the last match, but out of nowhere, we just died. But best we can do. But I want to say thank you to the 49 people. Holy crap. That's way more than I've ever had in a stream ever come out and watch me play, hear my thoughts. And, yeah. Thank you so much for showing up. End the stream now, but tune in back at Friday night, 9:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, as I will do my typical Friday night, late night stream. And then hopefully I will actually have Phoenix Hawks and a Butterbee by then, and we will try those out. And I'll be basicing and eliting those mechs then. But for now, thank you so much for showing up, and good hunting.